All right, so it looks like the Indiana Pacers are ready to just embark on a full rebuild, and that was based on a report earlier this week from The Athletic, Shams Charania and Bob Kravitz. They are currently 11-16 right now. They are 13th in the Eastern Conference, and they were supposed to actually be expected to be higher than that after hiring Rick Carlisle in the offseason off of the firing of Nate Bjorkman, who was hired last year to replace Nate McMillan, who was, in my opinion, just unjustly fired after he provided really some good years in Indiana. Now it has become apparent that this team really still has no identity. They're 3-12 in close games this year. The Domantas Sabonis and Myles Turner lineup, while they have found ways to make it work at times, it just really hasn't produced the results that everybody wants. So it's become apparent that it's time to just blow the team up. They're boring. They have no identity. And apparently, front office ownership feels the same way. T.J. McConnell is out for a while now after having surgery. T.J. Warren still hasn't played this year. Caris LeVert, who they got in that mega four-team Harden trade last year, hasn't really played well either. And the Malcolm Brogdon extension was kind of confusing at the time and is now even more confusing considering that they're nowhere near a playoff team and they're going to blow it up now. But now you can't trade Brogdon because you signed him to the extension during the season. But it looks like they're ready for a fire sale, and I already did a video on the Charlotte Hornets on centers that they should trade for, and I kind of already linked Myles Turner to them, and I still really like that for them. I think that's the better fit, even though Domantas Sabonis, who I want to talk about in this video instead of Turner, I think is the better player. Turner is the better fit, the better defender, and I just think his skill set fits better in Charlotte. But Domantas Sabonis is a two-time All-Star. His offensive game is really funky and fun. He's a top three passing big in the league. I just wanted to really quickly do a video on teams that I think should trade for Domantas Sabonis because now ownership has given the Pacers front office the blessing to rebuild. They don't really like to rebuild. With that being said, I'm going to list real quickly the teams that I think should trade for Domantas Sabonis. If you have an idea of which team should trade for Domantas Sabonis, I would love to hear your thoughts in the comments below if you think I'm missing anything. But I've looked through the teams and thought about, do they really need Domantas Sabonis in this situation? What would they give up? What assets do they have? And what about situation, age timeline, all that stuff. So let's get started. Number one, I think Domantas Sabonis would be really interesting on the Boston Celtics. Now, Domantas Sabonis, to me, in the offensive role, he would kind of just be a souped-up Al Horford the first stint when he was in Boston, playing off of Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown, even though Jaylen Brown is out now with a hamstring injury. I can just see Sabonis' skill set fitting really well around those two wings. Both can obviously score the ball. They're still exploring their playmaking abilities. I mean, they're only like 22 and 23 respectively, so they're still filling out their offensive game. But they're not necessarily at the level in their playmaking where it's making the other teammates better. I just think Domantas Sabonis, he's an all-star. He is in walking 20-12-6. Those were his numbers last year. I think his numbers have taken a dip this year because Carlisle has him posting up less, but I think the Celtics would really be able to get a boost in their offense. They're 16th in offensive rating right now per cleaning the glass, and I think adding somebody with Domantas Sabonis' skill set would really give a boost to this Celtics team. Now, it would be tough because the Celtics are primarily a switching team, and while Domantas Sabonis isn't a negative defender, he does have his limitations with his, you know, short wingspan, slower foot speed, but I could see him being able to adjust playing drop coverage and then maybe switch everything else at the other positions or something like that. I don't know, Celtics fans, maybe you can chime in on this one, but I actually am really intrigued with a Domantas Sabonis fit in Boston. Number two, this would be kind of a weird one because it's kind of in a rebuilding situation, but I would love to see Domantas Sabonis on the Detroit Pistons. I'm not the biggest Killian Hayes fan in the world, but I do acknowledge that he is 20 years old and can still turn into something. I don't know if it's the franchise guard that people look for, but Cade Cunningham is the franchise, and to pair Cade with somebody like Sabonis would be really awesome. Just a big and a guard who I think could fit really well together, especially in some type of dribble handoff action. You got two players with really high basketball IQs, and then you could fit Killian Hayes around that. I know beef stew, I love beef stew, but getting an all-star at 25 years old, I still think that would kind of fit the timeline for the Pistons. Maybe you give up Jeremy Grant's contract because Jeremy Grant hasn't really put up the semi-efficient scoring that he put up last year. The Pistons' young talent, I think, would benefit by playing with somebody like Domantas Sabonis. Third team I have is the Sacramento Kings. This one's pretty simple. The Kings just need to add talent. I know the Kings have won three in a row, but if you just look at the three teams they played, you know, a Clippers team without Paul George, the Orlando Magic with, you know, Jalen Suggs being out, and the Magic, you know, being really young, one of the youngest teams in the NBA. I mean, that's this three-game win streak, it's good for Sacramento because it's their first three-game win streak of the season. Wow. But they need some change. They need to infuse some real talent with that roster, get an all-star talent like Sabonis. And I think Sabonis, no matter what you think about him or how he made the all-star team, he's a legit, really good offensive player. And the Kings haven't had a passing big like that in a very long time. As you can imagine, since, you know, the Vlade Divac, Chris Webber days, DeMarcus Cousins was a good passer as well, but Domantas Sabonis, 20-12-6. Those were his numbers last year. Very efficient scorer, very good offensive rebounder. I think he can raise the defensive ceiling of the Kings a little bit just because he's very intelligent. And like I mentioned earlier, you can play him in some schemes and he'll be intelligent enough to figure it out. But right now the Kings are 15th in offensive rating and they're supposed to have a bunch of guards that are supposed to boost that offensive rating, try to get back up to the top 10 last year. But that clearly isn't the case. I think if you trade someone like De'Aaron Fox and Marvin Bagley, who has actually been really solid since Alvin Gentry has given him a role when he took over as head coach, if you make up a trade like that, you could start Tyrese Halliburton and Davion Mitchell and then pair them around a really good center like Domantas Sabonis. The Kings just need some talent there, and I really think that would be doing wonders for Sacramento. This is kind of a funky one, but I would really like to see Domantas Sabonis with the Spurs. And I think pairing Sabonis with all the young guards on that team, like DeJounte Murray, Lonnie Walker, and Keldon Johnson is just a big bully. The guy is basically a bull in the china shop. Can't forget younger guys like Devin Vassell, who has all the makings of being a hellacious defender in the NBA. And you would automatically have one of the best backup centers in the NBA in Jakob Poeltl, who is having a fantastic year and is a really, really good defender, borderline elite defender. But the Spurs are just in a youth movement right now. Adding somebody like Sabonis to fit in with Pop's system, a player that intelligent playing for Pop, I just would love to see that combination personally. The Spurs also would get a big jump in their offense. I mean, they're 25th in offensive rating right now. And then a fifth team, I think the Washington Wizards should trade for Domantas Sabonis. This is coming on the heels of Bradley Beal basically making comments that we really haven't heard from him the last few years, talking about taking control of his own destiny and being selfish, not signing an extension right away if he was offered it. And if you're a Wizards fan, you kind of got to start playing it both ways now. You kind of got to prepare and act like Bradley Beal won't take the extension. So trading for an all-star talent like Domantas Sabonis and pairing him with all the young guys and current signings, like keeping Kyle Kuzma, Spencer Dinwiddie, Rui Hachimura is going to come back soon, Denny Avdija. I would trade away Montrezl Harrell because while I think he's a really good regular season player, I just think he could be exploited in the playoffs. And I know Daniel Gafford has just been fucking awesome for the Wizards as a defensive anchor, but Domantas Sabonis once again is the better player. He should start, and then Daniel Gafford would just be a really nice backup to have, especially as Thomas Bryant continues to come back from his ACL injury. And then you still have other young guards like Aaron Holiday, who I'm still a really big fan of, Corey Kispert, who is already showing me that he just kind of knows how to play basketball within himself, always moving and cutting. And look, Bradley Beal is kind of having a down year. I think Bradley Beal is still one of the elite players in the NBA. He's just having a really down shooting year. But you got to start preparing, like Bradley Beal might not commit to you guys. And so maybe you offer him up in a trade for Sabonis. I don't know. I can't see Bradley Beal in Indiana, but if you're the Wizards, you got to try something or be in proactive mode, especially on this recent slide you were on before, you know, the double overtime win against the Detroit Pistons. The Wizards offense has kind of low-key been bad all year. They've kind of been winning on the heels of their defense and winning in clutch games. The Wizards are currently 19th in offensive rating, and having somebody like Domantas Sabonis would obviously boost that. So those are my five teams I think should trade for Domantas Sabonis. Again, I'm sure there are other teams out there that are intriguing. I just couldn't see it personally. But maybe, you know, you can make the case. I want you to leave a case in the comments below, which teams you think should make a play for Sabonis. And thanks for watching as always.